Hey, good people. This is Craig for Qigong presented by Tuervo. Think we got another couple of minutes before we start class, but thanks again for joining, checking out this practice. I'm just getting set up, making sure that you can hear me. I got the camera set up correctly. Always good to have participation for those who are joining live through Facebook Live. Write any comments. I'll try to respond and always appreciate the feedback. For those who are watching the replay, thanks again. My name is Craig. I'll be your Qigong facilitator today. And for those who are new to Qigong, wondering what this practice is all about, Qigong is an ancient Chinese health, wellness, energy practice. Qigong is spelled Qigong, the Qi, said as qi, that represents energy, our life force, breath. And gong, spelled Gong, that means to work with, to cultivate. So in this practice, we'll be working with our energy. And Qigong is a great practice for shifting your awareness into your body. Can be used as a moving meditation, a way to relax, become present. It's quite an experience, so hope you enjoy this practice. I'll begin in a couple of minutes. And one thing I want to mention for this practice is that this is self-care. This is a healing practice. So do what feels good for you. Listen to your body, listen to your wisdom. Go at your own pace. If you want to take breaks, go for it. If you want to modify any of the movements I'm doing, go for it. Listen to yourself, trust yourself, and take care of yourself. I'll try to give prompts and cues in regards to what I'm doing as we're doing the practice. Most of this practice is going to be slow, gentle movements that sync the body with the breath. But at times there might be some tapping, there might be a time where you stand still, and I'll let you know when those are coming up. And always, again, do what feels good for you. And we'll start this class. Let's start it right now. Here we go. So welcome again. I'll be doing this practice standing, but it can be done seated and even laying down again. The moves can be modified, but I'll let you know if there are ones that are particular or prefer to be standing. But most of the movements for this class today are just moving the arms. And let's begin this practice. And pretty much start every practice this way. Align the three treasures. And the three treasures are body, breath, and mind. And the reason we align these three treasures of body, breath, and mind is to help us get the most out of our Qigong practice and also just to take time to notice, acknowledge, and get ourselves prepared for the next 55 minutes. So we're going to start with aligning the body. One way we can do that is we can bring both feet together. Just noticing how that feels. And I just want you to just notice and take a look at your surroundings, making sure you have enough space for yourself, enough space to move, to step out, to swing the arms around, to move the hands up and down. And just look around. And that's just a way to help your body just become aware of the environment that allows you to just feel safer, knowing what's around. And let's begin aligning the body. So, if you'd like, with your weight in the right foot, sit down, step out with the left. So the feet are about shoulder width, hip width apart. Whatever feels good for you. And again, noticing the awareness, noticing how your feet feel, noticing the soles of your feet. Is the weight distributed equally? Noticing what would feel comfortable for you. Now let's align the rest of the body. Knees are soft, so if you like, you can gently lock and unlock your knees. Tailbone is tucked under the spine. Arms are relaxed down by the side. Shoulders are dropped down. Hands are open. Fingers can be spread apart if that feels comfortable for you. Spine is upright. And if you'd like, there's an opportunity to take some time to release tension and stretch the shoulders and the neck. I like to do shoulder rolls and neck rotations. Do whatever you like or whatever feels good for you, or you can follow me. I'm going to start with the shoulder rolls. I'll do three, and actually, yeah, I'll do three rolling forward and three rolling back. Now reverse the movement. I'll take some time to do some neck rotations. Just being gentle and kind with the neck. And when you're all set with those neck shoulder tension releasing exercise, you can just bring your hand over the spine. And now let's just bring our awareness to the head, the face. Just notice it. Bringing your awareness to your eyes. Can you relax the eyes, soften the gaze? Bringing awareness to the brow and the jaw. Can you ease tension in this area? Can you relax the jaw? Can you even unhinge the jaw? Checking in with the mouth. Is the mouth relaxed? A suggestion is to have the tongue connected to the palate, the roof of the mouth. And the tongue can be connected or touching the back of two front teeth. Just noticing how that feels. And lastly, this is imagine there's a string that comes down from the ceiling or the sky. It connects to the top of your head. And it pulls you upright, but yet you're relaxed. Alright, now let's move into aligning the breath. This Qigong practice, we do what is known as Dantian breathing. Dantian representing the energy field that is around the lower abdomen, in front of the spine. The other way this breathing is known as is diaphragmatic breathing, belly breathing. And the way we do this is as we inhale and take a deep breath, and as the lungs fill with air, the abdomen expands. As we exhale, the abdomen softens, lungs empty of air. So again, as you inhale, lungs fill with air, navel moves away from the spine as the abdomen expands. Exhale, Abdomen softens, lungs empty. And the reason behind doing this type of breathing is that it helps us relax, especially when you combine it with extending exhalations. This taps into parasympathetic nervous system, helps us shift into more rest and relaxation. And lastly, we're going to align the mind. The mind is so important. So just bring your attention to what you're thinking about right now. Where is your awareness? And I'll check in with you throughout the practice on where is your awareness? What is your focus on? Well, let's set intention to bring our awareness to the present moment. And there's different ways that we can guide ourselves back to the present moment. We can check in with our environment, our external environment, sight, sound, taste, touch. Or we could tune into our internal environment, checking in with our sensations, our breath, our heartbeat, energy. Do what feels comfortable for you. Do what allows you to feel safe, but allow you to practice being present. And now that we have aligned the body, the breath, and the mind, we're going to begin this practice. We're going to start off with full body breathing. So the hands relax down by the side. We're going to start out inhaling the hands up in front of the body, towards the sky. Exhale, hands down by the side. And restart that movement. Inhale, hands up. Exhale, hands down. Going at your own pace and speed. Noticing what you feel. Modifying the movement so it works for your capacity, your body. Let's do two more repetitions in this direction. Now we're going to reverse the movement. When you find your hands flowing down in final repetition, we're going to inhale the hands up by the side. When the hands make it overhead, we're going to exhale hands down from the body. And noticing what you feel as you change the direction of the movement. Do this for 3 more repetitions. My final repetition, and I'll now transition to the next movement. So I'm going to bring my hands to the front of the lower abdomen, the dantian. Palms will be turned up, fingers are going to be pointed towards the other. A little bit of space in between the hands. Just noticing how this feels. Going to transition to the next movement. So we're going to inhale the hands up to heart height. Turn palms over. Exhale. Allow the hands to flow down. Lungs down. So inhale, lungs flow in the air. Hands come up to the heart. Flip the hands over. Exhale, hands flow down. Empty. What do you notice? What do you sense? Do this gesture three more times. This being my final repetition, I'm going to transition to the next movement. And we're actually going to inhale the hands back up to heart height. And we're going to bring our hands together as if we're holding a ball. Fingers will point up or out. Just noticing how you feel. Noticing what you connect with. Noticing what you sense. Noticing what comes to your mind's eye. Now we're going to extend the hands out, a slight bend in the elbows, and let's begin the next movement. We're going to inhale, allow the hands to move. Open up, out to the sides, look up. Exhale, bring the hands back close together. Without tension, moving forward. Inhale, look up, arms spread apart, feel the stretch. Exhale, look forward. Bring the hands back close together without touching. Noticing if you sense any energy sensations. Let's do this two more times. Let's just take a moment after we finish our final repetition to check back in with the hands that are holding a ball. And again, just whatever ball comes to your mind, whatever you sense, whatever you connect with. Just noticing how that feels. If you'd like, you take time just rotate that ball. Moving that ball in whatever way you want to express yourself with the ball. What do you connect with right now? How would you want to move it?
rotate it, expand it, make it smaller, make it larger, move it around. Just taking time. Do what is calling to you in this moment. Let's just bring this moment of exploration to a close. So let's return to that initial position of having the arm extended, slight bend the elbows. And we're going to transition to the next movement. We're going to turn the palms facing towards the chest. We're going to inhale in the hands, exhale, all the hands trace over the body. And we're going to swivel the palms around. We're going to inhale the hands up to shoulder height. Turn the palms over, exhale, hands flow back down. We start the movement, inhale hands back up. Exhale, flip the palms over, allow the hands to flow back down. The hands can flow past body. What do you notice? What do you sense? How would it feel to extend the exhale? Noticing what works for you. There are lots of variations for this specific movement. I'll go through a couple. I don't name ones that you like. Go for it. Follow what works for you. I'll begin with sinking and rising. Time to exhale, the hands are blowing down. You can sink, slight bend the knees and hips. Inhale, rise back up. Exhale, sink. Want to make it more of a balance practice. As you inhale, you can rise up onto your toes, on the balls of the feet, and on the exhale, you can lift the toes up, sit the weight to the heels. That's optional, and it's okay if you stumble, it's just a practice. Another variation involves shifting the weight on the bottom of the feet, so it's more like a foot massage. So when you inhale the hands up, you're going to shift the weight while keeping the feet planted to the front of the feet. And on the exhale, you're going to shift the weight to the back of each foot. And again, feet stay planted on the ground, and you shift the weight forward. And back around the bottom of the feet. Next variation involves bringing the feet together and stepping the feet apart. So on the inhale, step the left foot in towards the right foot. On the exhale, left steps away from right. Now we'll alternate, inhale, right steps towards left. Exhale, right steps away from left. You can incorporate other variations into this movement. You can do some sinking, some rising. You want to make this balance practice. As you step in on the foot, you can actually even lift the leg up. Works for you, what feels good for you. Maybe you just want to stay in one position and just move the arms up and down. Just noticing your awareness, noticing the flow. Let's do two more repetitions. One pass for each side, each leg. All right. Let's check back in. Just noticing how weight in the feet are distributed. Noticing the hands, the knees, the elbows. Notice softness. Are you able to notice tension? Are you able to be with that tension? Kindness to it? Possibly release it? Just noticing. Or just noticing your surroundings. Noticing what you see, hear. Just bringing awareness to the present. And let's move into shaking. Shaking, qigong. It's just a great way of moving the body, releasing the stress. So let's start. We can start simply by just shaking the hand. If you like, you can just shake there. Or you can just move it into the rest of your body, move into your arms. Move it to your torso, move it to your head, move it to your hips, move it to your legs, move it into your feet. Also shake and release stress out of it. So you can let a sigh or a hum. Whatever feels good, seems that combination works really well. And I'll still take some time to do some living breaths. Just do three. Those who don't know what living breaths are, it's just when you're taking a deep breath. Inhale. Now the exhale. Just let out a sigh. Could be yawn. Just any way that allows us to express and release stress vocally, orally, audibly. And we'll do that in just a moment. As always, do what feels comfortable for you. I'll do three. And on the inhale, when I say inhale, we'll take a deep breath together. On the exhale, just whatever feels good to you, we'll let out a sigh. Ready? One, two, three. Inhale. All right. Let's do number two. Inhale. Let's do one more, last one. Inhale. All right. Let's go stop the shaking practice. Let's bring the hands out to the side. Let's bring the hands overhead. Bring the hands out to the front of the body. And let's bring the hands behind the body. If you feel comfortable, you can just, if you like, you can bend and get closer to the ground, the earth, get that good energy. And we'll bring the shaking to a conclusion in 20 seconds, but however you want to shake the next 20 seconds, do what feels good for you. And with the next 10 seconds, let's begin to slow down. If you like, you can come to stillness. Right now, stillness. Much, you can come to swaying. It sort of allows you to be comfortable at the moment. If you're comfortable with stillness, you can take time to turn inwards. If turning inwards is a bit much, you can stick with swaying, notice your environment, noticing what your eyes are drawn to. Let's use this time just again just to be. Not worried about doing, just being in this moment. If you like, you can bring your hands to your body for healing, for connecting with the energy centers, whatever feels good for you. I'll bring my hands to the heart, the abdomen, the antenna centers. Noticing. We're all set, just allowing hands to pull down. We'll do the second half of this Qigong practice. I'll do mostly flowing and some stretching movements. Start off with some movements from holding Qigong. Start off with spinal cord breathing. So it's a lot of hands to float up. Arms will open as you perch the upper back. On the exhale, we're going to bring the forearms together. Tuck the chin towards the chest. Inhale. Arch upper back to cup. Exhale. Forearms together, round the back, tuck the chin in. We'll do this 3 more times. So inhale, open up, exhale, round. Do this one more time. Inhale. Exhale. We can open up one last time. And we're just going to exhale out of here. So just flow out and down to the sides. We're going to move into knocking on the temple bell, knocking the temple bell. Start turning at the waist, allowing the hands to flow. When you feel comfortable, you can allow your hands to tap the lower back and lower abdomen. Front hand can tap lower abdomen, back hand taps lower back. These exercises help us warm up the spine. If you like, you can tap the chest, the front hand, noticing how that feels. And this movement, just allowing the hands to continue to tap the body in the moment, we'll just allow them to float off the body. And all set, just come, return to center. Just noticing how that feels. Noticing the sensations, noticing your awarenesses right now. Noticing what you feel in your feet, your hands. And let's move into an exercise that allows us to warm the spine by doing some side bends. So let's begin. Hands supporting the heavens. So let's start with the palms turned up, hands in front of the lower down in the waist. We're going to inhale the hands up. We're going to interlock the fingers around the face. Exhale, press up if you like. You can stretch and then release the hands, allowing them to flow down. Do that one more time, and then we'll incorporate side bends. Hands up. Interlock the fingers. Stretch up. Exhale, release the hands. Now we're going to incorporate side bends. So, we won't release the hands, we'll just move into the side bends. And we interlock the hands. Exhale, stretch up. You can rise up onto your toes. And inhale, slide your hands. Just drop a little bit above the head. And now on the exhale, we're going to turn towards the left side, feeling the stretch on the right side of the body. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, stretch towards the right, feeling the stretch on the left side of the body. Inhale, back to center. Allow hands to release on the exhale. We're going to do that two more times. Go inhale. Interlock the fingers. Exhale, stretch, press up. Inhale, allow the hands to drop down a little bit. Exhale, press out. Body. Inhale, bring the hands back to center. Exhale, stretch to the right, feel on the left side. Inhale, return to the center. Exhale, release the hands. It's one more time. Go ahead, hold the pace and speed. Noticing how you feel.
Noticing what you're feeling.
Shoulders, your arms, bottom of your feet. Feel comfortable checking with your breath, checking with your energy. And let's move into some more flowing movements. Let's start with opening chest, a favorite mug, and a simple exercise. And here's how we work. We're going to inhale the hands up. Up to chest height. Continue to open the hands out and apart to the side. And exhale, allow hands to flow down. If you like, you can sink them. Inhale, hands float up and rise back up. Continue to open the hands apart. Exhale, cancel down, and you can sink down. Let's do this a few more times. All right, we can do another beholden Qigong gesture called the pulse monkey. We'll bring up left hand, palm facing up and out, and we will take the right hand, circle it around, and exhale this palm, draws over the left arm here, right palm turns up, and then circle the left hand. Left hand trades over the right hand, and circle right hand. Just noticing what you sense. If you're looking for a breathing pattern, on the exhale you can trace over the other hand. On the inhale you circle. Let's do two more repetitions, one more pass with each hand. And all set, slow hands, so foot down, relax down by. Be a good time to take some time, do some deep inhales and sigh on the exhales. If you like, as you're performing that, bring the hands to the body. Yeah, let's take time to do two deep inhales, exhale, and sigh. So let's inhale. Let's do one last one. Inhale. down, a favor on the body. Sighing is a way of relaxing the body. It resets the nervous system. Let's move into some other gestures. You can do a simple one called lifting ball. This is coordinating the hand and legs. And so bring one hand over the right hand in front of the right leg. And we're going to do it to lift the right hand. We'll lift the right leg. Balance it. Hand and leg drop down, and we'll reverse that. Inhale, left hand, left leg. Exhale. We'll do this a few times. Two more repetitions, one more pass to each arm side. All right. Let's do a movement for the April Kings. And we're going to do quite a bit, but let's start off. Bring the hands to the lower back, the kidneys, and just bring some warmth and just noticing the energy in that area. And what we're going to do is perform a gesture. We're going to inhale, and then exhale. We've just got a lot of hands, trace down the back of the legs. Inhale, we're going to draw the hands up a little bit. We're going to bring the hands, take it to waist, we're going to flip off the body. Inhale, hands up, overhead. Exhale, the hands, palms facing down the body and facing over the body. And when the hands make it to around the soul practice, bring the palm of the hands back to kidneys, the lower back, and restart the movement. So exhale, chase the hands down the legs, inhale, draw them up the inlet, and float up off the body. Hands come forward ahead, exhale, palms to turn towards yourself as it trace over the body. Let's do this gesture two more times. At your own pace and speed. Position. And just slow down. Just become relaxed down by the side. And just noticing. We have about 10 minutes of class left. We have a few more gestures. literally holding Qigong. Best gesture. Kuan Yin, turn the rainbow. So, turn the palms. Let's do about head and solar plexus. You're going to inhale on the left hand up. Circle the round. Drop both hands up to about chest height. Turn both hands down, travel to the legs. Now we're going to reverse the movement. Go to the other side, inhale, right hand up, and circle the round. Exhale, circle the right hand round. Inhale, travel both hands up. Turn the hands, bottom floor down. Then we'll repeat the sequence back with the left hand. Circle, hand out, and around, inhale, both hands up, turn both arms down, let's do this again with the right hand, do two more repetitions, one more pass with each hand. Let's do the last repetition. Turn both palms over and slow the hands. Gently slow down and be relaxed. And just noticing where your awareness is. Noticing what you sense, checking in with your environment, internal, if you're comfortable with that, sensations, breath, or external, noticing what you sense, see, hear. And just being with that right now. And we'll transition to the next exercise. Another eight bouquet exercise. So we'll start by bringing the palms facing towards the body, bring them in, and we're going to exhale, open the palms, turn towards the right, inhale and head back to center, bring the palms facing towards the body, exhale, turn towards the left, palms facing out, feel the stretch in the neck, and then we turn back to center, bring back in. Exhale, turn towards the right. Its own pace and speed. Let's do this for two more repetitions. Also, it's slow, yeah. foot there. And just noticing. Let's take time to do a standing meditation. We'll do that for a few minutes. We have 3 minutes of time that we can do it. So let's move into embracing a tree. And we'll do that by inhaling the hands up in front of the body. Exhaling, turn the fingers towards each other. Just imagine the arms and hands circling around a tree. Could be embracing a tree, hugging a tree. You can add slight bend in the knees. And we're just going to stay in this posture. 3 minutes. But take time to readjust, take time for breaks. Shoulders drop down. If you want to, allow your hands to drop down periodically. If this is too much strain, do what feels good for you. It's just taking time to just be. Minute has passed. We have 2 more minutes to go. Just noticing where your awareness is. A deep sense. Between your hands, your feet, your environment. And we have 1 more minute to go. Soften. Let's bring kindness to the air. Just noticing where you're in the renaissance. We're almost there. Gently allow your hands to just flow down. Now we're going to do the closing this practice. So we're going to inhale, palms turned up towards the sky. Let's bring the left foot in towards the right foot. And as you inhale, inhale overhead, let's exhale. Turn the palms towards that sun. Take whatever we need from that practice, allow the hands to draw down. Let's do this movement 2 more times without moving the legs. Gathering, inhale the hands up. Exhale. Take it in whatever you need. it is for a total of 3 repetitions. Close this practice, and at this point in time, I will not be marrying, so I'm going to bring up my right hand. And right hand is in the form of the soft fist, and this represents yang energy, daylight, sun, action. And I'm going to bring up my left hand, palm is open, up towards the sky. Left hand will represent yin energy, representing earth and moon, relaxation. And let's bring the hands together, left covers right hand. As we bring them both to center, take this opportunity in the body self for engaging in self-care. Cultivating energy, working with mindfulness, and I want to thank you for checking out this practice. Thanks for your time, your energy, your presence, and I want to take time to thank Choi Bo, Valley Qigong, Darren Zhang, and a lot of great people. Great communities that supported me and allowed me to facilitate this past video. Let me know if you have any thoughts, comments, feedback, always appreciated. Until next time, live well, be well, and take care of yourself.